Alright guys, and welcome to the next video. I'm going to talk to you today about the company AMD. Yesterday AMD had their financial analyst day, basically where they showcased and announced their roadmap for the next couple of years, where they talked about their graphics cards they're going to be releasing, their APUs and their CPUs. Now, for the purpose of this video today, I'm going to mainly be talking about their CPU, which is coming out next year, which is called the Zen. There was leaks a few weeks back where we were told the Zen would be coming out, and Tech of Tomorrow actually did a video on it talking about some of the things that we would have expected to see. There's still a lot of things in speculation as to the clock speeds that the Zen processor is going to hit. Basically, with the Zen, we've been told that AMD is going to be using a technology called SMT, simultaneous multi-threading, which is basically the AMD equivalent of hyper-threading, which Intel have been doing for years now. Basically, with this technology, AMD is boasting a 40% increase instructions per clock, but like I said, we haven't been told the clock speeds that the Zen's going to be able to hit. We know the Zen is going to be coming out in 2016. We know that there is a new socket for it, the AM4. And we know that the new socket is going to be able to support DDR4 memory. So, like I said, there's a lot of speculation in it even now, because we don't know exactly how good them sockets and how good the processors are going to overclock, what kind of speeds we're going to see. But we do know there's new technology involved. We know AMD is also moving towards the Intel way of things, where they're actually trying to become more energy efficient. You know, the R9 series of graphics cards, they generated a lot of heat and they ran noisy. And the same with the processors as well. They generated a lot of heat and people didn't particularly like that. So they're trying to become more energy efficient and basically try and compete again with Intel. So if you have any opinions on the matter, throw down a comment in the comment section below. I want to hear what you think. We know AMD have been talking about their new graphics cards as well, where they're actually coming out this quarter, and they've boasted high bandwidth, so that's always a good thing to take a look at. As well as this, AMD are developing their 7000 series, which are Carrizo architecture for their CPUs, and this is going to be used in notebooks. This is coming out this year, so we'll have to wait for obviously a year until we get the Zen processor and, you know, later on the Zen Plus. Basically at launch we're going to have a very strong desktop based CPU for the Zen, and then later we're going to have the lower end CPUs and the APUs of the Zen based architecture come out after. So we might see them end of 2016, 2017, we don't know yet. Also, for anybody that doesn't know, AMD has recently partnered up with the company Avid, deal with a lot of video editing and a lot of audio editing. They're very famous for producing the software Pro Tools. With AMD partnering up with Avid and having access to their technology, innovation and creations, you know, God knows what they could be planning for next year or years to come. AMD are also boasting low latency cache on the new Zen processors. So basically this will be useful in any kind of application which utilizes multiple cores, like rendering or copying over files. But there's still going to be a lot of things announced in the coming weeks and coming months that we're going to have to look out for to actually get a better idea on the technical specifications of the Zen processor. The Zen processor is rumored to have 16 cores. If this is the case, then this would be a good stamp in the market for AMD, and they might actually have a chance of competing with Intel. However, we don't know exactly how well this processor is going to perform in everyday applications, because The thing is, it's all good having more cores, but if you don't have the programs or the utilities there that utilize the cores, they're basically rendered useless. And the thing is as well with AMD and Intel, in the past, AMD's multi-core performance, basically their clock speeds were shared out per core. So if you were running like 3.5 gigahertz on an 8 core, the actual speed, the clock speed would be divided up between the 8 individual cores. Whereas with the likes of Intel, they would have that clock speed per core. And this helped an awful lot with the likes of video rendering and things like that, where it would be a hell of a lot quicker using the same clock speeds because each core had this. So we just need to see how the Zen performs against its competitors. We know Intel are bringing out a new line of processors called the Skylake in 2016. So it could be a battle to the death of new strong-ended CPUs. It'll be a good time for PC enthusiasts and gamers alike, and I'll sure be glad to see it. As far as my opinion goes on the Zen processor and the AM4 socket, I'm going to have to wait a few more months to actually see some hard numbers and decide whether or not I want to upgrade. You know, I might be due one at the time, and I'll have to definitely take a look at, you know, it and the Intel equivalent. I ain't going to make any rash decisions. You know, at the end of the day, I need to see some hard numbers on the Zen processor and the AM4 socket. The great thing about the AM3 Plus socket, which I'm actually using at the minute, it was very good for overclocking the processors, and I use an 8320, and that thing overclocks and overvolts and undervolts like a champ. So, you know, I'll just have to see some hard numbers and see what I think, you know. If you have any opinions on the new Zen CPU from AMD, or the new line of graphics cards, or anything to do with AMD or Intel, you know, in the next coming months that's coming up, fire it down in the comment section below. I'd like to hear from you, and I'll try and get back to you as soon as possible. That's going to wrap up my video, folks, on the new AMD Zen CPU. You can follow me anytime at For The Banter NI on Twitter and Facebook. If you liked the video, throw a like on it. If you really liked it, subscribe to me. Until next time, my friends, goodbye.